What's up, Cthulhu? How's it going, everybody? How you doing, buddy? You said you were gonna stream tonight, but decided not to because weren't feeling up to it. Hope you're feeling better. Thank you for the host. Hello, everybody. This is Luckless Lovelocks bringing you some more Bloodborne. I know earlier I said I was taking a longer break. I didn't realize it was going to be like an 8-hour break. I wanted it to be more like a few hours to eat and then I get back to it. But I fell asleep. I fell asleep after eating, as I'm apt to do. Anyways, I want to get back into Bloodborne. Such an amazing game. We just killed Amelia, Vicar Amelia, who I believe is supposed to be kind of like the top priest in the Healing Church. So let's just see, what does Vicar mean exactly? Okay, so a vicar is a representative, deputy, or substitute, anyone acting in the person of or agent for a superior. A sense of at second hand. Okay. So the title appears in a number of Christian ecclesiastical contexts, but also as an administrative title or title modifier. Huh. So, in Catholic canon law, a vicar is the representative of any ecclesiastic entity. So there's different roles they could perform. Vicars exercise authority as the agents of the bishop of the diocese. Most of them have ordinary powers. Blah, 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 blah. Okay, the point is that she was easily the most powerful beast we've faced so far. So she must have been a high-ranking official in the church, and also she was praying to protecting this beast's head. When we touched it, we saw a cutscene of a man named Lawrence talking to I can't remember his name. So bad with names. Natalie Rose, what's up? I don't know. I'll probably remember it in a bit. Anyways, the idea is they had some kind of disagreement about how they were approaching this. I don't want to say too much, but like a solution to a problem. So they have some kind of philosophical difference. Willem, Master Willem. They have some kind of philosophical difference. And Lawrence did call Willem Master, which means that there's some kind of mentor-student relationship going on. I'm pretty good. How are you doing, Natalie Rose? So, it's weird that we got this flashback. Oh yeah, and Willem said, oh, you look to betray me. And he said, Lawrence said, something to the effect of, you just won't listen to me. So he's got some kind of idea that Master Willem's not willing to accept. And then before he left, he said, I won't forget the adage that you've taught us to fear the old blood. So it's interesting that we touched this skull to get that flashback that kind of leads us to believe that this might actually be Lawrence's skull. And you see that it's been cleaved almost in two by some kind of weapon. So Someone killed him. They go for amazing friends right now. Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. Me too. Natalie, are you doing all right? So now that we've killed Vicar Amelia. Oh, and we also got this pendant, which let's read the description again. It's not that telling. Thought there would be more to it. This pendant passed down among the vicars who head the Healing Church. Right, there we go. So she was the head of the Healing Church. It's a reminder of the cautionary adage words that will open the gates of Bergenworth. So we talked, we went to a door earlier and said they would not open unless we gave them the password. And now we have the password. So we could go there if we wanted to Bergenworth. But we're gonna look around Yharnam a bit, because I think things have probably changed since we killed Vicar Amelia. Didn't have the best day, but my friends helped cheer me up. Well, I hope that I can help to cheer you up as well. This game's kind of dark, so it's not exactly the best pick-me-up game. But you'll get to hear a really interesting story, or part of a really interesting story. So I'm gonna go back to the Hunter's Dream first and just do some things. Baron, what's up? Wish you could have been there too, man. What have you been up to? I haven't seen you in a long time. On the YT. Excellent. You're in the right place then, Natalie Rose. This is a very dark game. So, I'll do a quick recap of the story. We kind of came to this place where we seem to be a foreigner, probably suffering from some kind of illness, and we came here because we discovered we're told that Yharnam, which is the city that we're in, has some kind of miracle cure. They administer blood to cure people, basically. So we're given some blood, and we're sent on this this quest to find the Pale Blood. That seems to be the overarching quest that we're on. But ultimately, since we were administered this blood, we've become hunters, and we're meant to hunt beasts. So something has caused some kind of disease which transforms people into beasts, and we're supposed to kill those beasts. Dark things make me happy. So we've slain a few of them already, the last one being Vicar Amelia. Looks like there's another item here. So I think by killing Vicar Amelia, we've actually unlocked the ability to start the DLC for this game. The Eye of a Blood-Drunk Hunter beckons hunters to the Hunter's Nightmare. A deformed creature will whisk you away outside Odin Chapel. I'm not going to go do the DLC yet, because from what I've heard and what I've seen, it's very difficult. And I'm only level 30. I'm probably going to wait till I'm like level maybe even 90 or something like that before I go. Hey, wrestler, what's up? Sits on Lux's couch. There's plenty of room. Plenty of room for you guys. Always room. Hey, Kiwi. Thanks for dropping by. Thank you. So this game is kind of interesting that it doesn't allow you to do the DLC right away. You have to go through a bit of the game before you can unlock it. So the other thing that I can do with that pendant is I can turn it into a gem. Gold blood gem. Is there descriptions for these? So we could use the gems to fortify our weapons. Or that is, okay, there it is. Most radial blood gems have effects that bear upon physical attacks, and this golden radial blood gem, kept for generations within the church, strengthens attacks against those afflicted intensely by beasthood. When clerics began transforming into unspeakable beasts, the church needed something to retaliate with. Treat me well, Byron. I'm just borrowing it from a friend, so I don't actually own it. So let's take a look at this gem, see if it's worth equipping. And I'll repair my weapons. Can I fortify? Not yet. I need 3 whatever that is. Twin bloodstone shards. Okay. So in order to upgrade this further, I need twin bloodstone shards. I only have regular bloodstone shards. But what I can do is equip some blood jams. What you been doing, Byron? I haven't seen you around in like forever. Forever! So that attack versus beast is up 12.6%. I'm gonna equip it for now because I'm gonna be fighting a lot of beasts, I think, in the next little bit. Now I only have one blood tinged gemstone, I guess. Oh, look, there's someone crying. Is it the messengers? Maybe. Mabba. So I'm going to be talking a lot about the story, guys, while I'm playing. Because I really like the story in this game. Hope you don't mind that. Can I buy anything new? Nope. I don't really need to get blood vials. I'll pick them up, I think, as I go along. I could get the hand lantern. I think I'd rather just save my money and level up. Save my money and my blood. Just have a super potato internet on my phone. Oh, right. T-Mobile fixed it for a day. But it went back to crap. Fuck, Byron. I'm so sorry, dude. I'm so sorry, man. It's annoying. Like, you're paying for something, you want it to fucking work. I think vitality is gonna be key. Oh man, I wanna just pump a couple levels of vitality. I think I want, I don't know. Why not? Actually, no. Skill. Yeah, seriously. Seriously, Wrestler, get to work on that.
Farewell, good hunter. May you find your worth in the waking world.
Life without the internet readily available is king's nice, though. Kinda nice. Feel like a proper human being now. It's kind of funny how that works out. People think that they can't live without the internet, but then when you don't have it, to a certain degree, you feel quite a bit better.
Welcome home, good hunter.
Connect a bit more with people directly.
What is it you desire? Hunters have told me about the church, about the gods and their love. But do the gods love their creations? I am a doll created by you humans. Would you ever think to love me? Of course. I do love you. Isn't that how you've made me?
So she was made by humans, this doll. She's wondering if we love her.
Hunters have told me about the church.
Interesting. Decent time waking up with no problems. Isn't that funny? Maybe you should just not don't get internet, man. Don't get internet. Go like a few months without it. Do the sleep. I should probably be heading to bed. All right, Natalie. What's up, King of Soups? Welcome back. Good night. Good night, Natalie. Hope you feel better. Alright, Let's get back to Yharnam, and we are going to go to the Grand Cathedral. Yeah, let's go back to the Grand Cathedral. So this is where we fought Emilio. Yeah, Sandy, what's up, dude? Probably catch a luckless stream. So, Byron, you going to bed too, man? If you are, have a good night. I again here. Fuck. Okay, so let's see what it looks like outside since we've killed Emilia. So when we came in here, it was still daytime, but it looked like the sun was setting. And now it's dark. Night has fallen on Yharnam. And there's the moon. Isn't that cool, guys? I mean, obviously other games have that, but it's very important, this whole cycle of day night. Good night, Byron. I get your notifications because Twitch doesn't want me to follow you all this time. I've been missing out. You know what? You're not the first person to say that. That Blue Ninja said he had to refollow me, and some other people as well. It could be because I'm streaming from the PS4, maybe? I don't think so, though. Oh, shit. Stream is laggy for you again. It shouldn't be an issue on my end because I'm actually streaming from the PS4 and it's at a lower bitrate than I normally stream at. So I'd suggest checking to see if you were downloading anything or uploading something. Let's go take a look at the moon, guys. Man, the place looks totally different from earlier today. Video's normal sound is slow or not existent? That's weird. Is anyone else having sound problems? That sounds like a hardware thing on your end. If no one else is having that issue. Guy does not look happy. Oh, wow. Haven't noticed, okay. Look at how dark it is now. So something has drastically changed after killing Vicar Amelia. Could just be that time has passed. Or maybe it's something else. Not sure. Back in a few minutes. Okay. It's fucking so foreboding. But the moon is pretty small. And it's pretty high in the sky. You got a Luckless's online notification? Did you have to refollow me, Sandy? I did a few minutes ago. That's really annoying. It's really annoying that that happens. I like how the online notification was delayed. Okay, is this... Have I not triggered this before? Wow, I missed some stuff earlier. Let this guy walk by. So we can take on this guy alone. Yeah, I could have unlocked that. That would have made things a bit easier, I think, to get to Amelia. That's fine. Well, do y'all play Bloodborne when it's irrelevant and no one cares? I don't think this game will ever be irrelevant, Sandy. It's kind of timeless, very much like Dark Souls. So, I mentioned couple streams ago that because we've seen a lot of sarcophagus around, but they've mainly been adult ones, and we've only seen child sarcophagus, so child coffins in old Yharnam, but we've seen a lot of these old style strollers, children's strollers, all over the place in like Yharnam proper. And a lot of these creepy wheelchairs as well. So I think that's an important piece of information. No! Fuck, I hate those things. So scary. The sounds they make are so scary. Oh, okay. I'm tempted to let this guy take me, but I don't think I'm gonna do that yet. Why do you do that creepy... This fucking daycare area in Dead Space? I don't remember that. I don't remember the daycare area. Maybe I didn't get to it. Look at this guy. He doesn't like Odin Chapel. So let's see what's going on here. This woman seems to be frightened now. She seems to be a bit out of her mind, too. Just a bit. Just a bit. She was before we killed Amelia and the night fell, she was pretty strong of mind and blaming foreigners for the scourge of beasts that's befallen Bjarnum. And she was like, I know all your tricks, just stay away from me, even though we saved her life. Oh, and this is opened. That was not open before. Interesting. So what does he have to say?
Ah, the hunter. Alive and well, are ya? This here is a safe place. Stay as long as you like. But next time you're out on a hunt, remember what I asked. If you find any sane survivors, tell them to seek shelter at Erden Chapel.
Erden.
Because there's nothing to fear here.
That's one of my favorite characters in the game. I don't know what it is about him, but he just always makes me laugh. He's just like, nothing to fear here. I'm just gonna cackle eerily for a bit. So what I want to do is, there are some other people that we can save now that night has fallen. I just have to remember how to get to them. So that's what I'm going to be doing in the first part of this stream. I'm trying to find those guys that I can save. I can't remember if it's... I can't remember which area it's in. Forgot which one had those baby-like enemies. Oh, I remember now. I remember now. Yeah, I hate those. I hate those guys. The ones that have the three tentacles that shoot at you. Yeah, I remember that area where they're. It looks like they're doing experiments on babies. That game is great. Okay, there's a child's coffin. There's a child's coffin. So there are some up here also. I think it's this way. What I want to get to is that woman who seemed like a prostitute. I missed some items. Excellent, I need blood vials for sure. How did I miss these items before? Or maybe there's new items since the nighttime has come. There was one over here too. How do I get to that one? Let me climb up, see if I can get a better view. Numbing mist. Oh shit. Okay. This I could have used against Vicar Amelia. Flora to create a mist cloud that numbs a hunter's life essence and prevents restoration of HP. Said to be used by the Blood Hunters of Canehurst. This recipe is a secret closely guarded by the line of nobles inhabiting the castle. So we find out more about Castle Canehurst. And so they had hunters as well called Blood Hunters. And they just seem to be interested in stopping people from healing. So Vicar Amelia was a healer. That would have been good to have in that fight. But I could also use it against hunters in general. Love the little touches in this game. like a blanket on the rooftop over there. I wonder if I should fall down there. Let's try it. See where this takes us. Okay. What the wrestler? This might get us the item we were looking for. Maybe. Maybe not. Not. You can, man. Go for it. No one's stopping you. There's no bot in the chat, guys. You could literally put whatever you want. You could put anything. I'm trying to think how I get to those people again. Do I have to go back? You can put poop, yes. Can put poop. You can fucking spam symbols. You can use all the caps you want. You can fucking all kinds of swear words and shit. Feels vag, man. Central Yharnam. I think it was past this, wasn't it? Shit, fuck, cock, cunt, dick shit. Pussy wart? I don't think I've heard that one before, but alright. Good job, Cthulhu. I commend thee. You guys just do your thing over there. Oh no 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 no, this is not the right way. One day. So Cthulhu, you're streaming on Friday next, I think you said? What you gonna play? I'll make dummy accounts and try to get one through. Get one what? Pussy Pepe, the Kool-Aid Man, and Pete's tried to get approved. Like, did Did people just like spam Better Twitch TV emotes to try to get it approved? Find someone to approve it? Okay. Okay. Now it's just wildfire. She showed it accidentally for a second. I like how Twitch has this like has all these like meta communities. It's like meta community goals. Oh god. Okay, I don't want to take on three of these. One at a time, guys, please. One at a time. No, god, no! Is that like, I don't even know what it looks like. But is it something that she could have gotten like banned for? That's pretty funny. God damn, that does damage. So we'll end up sending Feels Vagman to a Twitch mod that doesn't care and just approves Pussy Pepe. The Better Twitch TV stuff. I've gone through the process before. Yeah, I don't really know how it works. Someone looks at it and can approve it. Yeah, you can lick it. I don't care. It's just three pussies. I have a lot of insight. Fair amount of insight, so I want to let that dissipate because it's gonna kill me if I don't, and he hits me again. Or you could tweet it to me. That's true. That is an option. Oh my god. Might kill me. Oh, that frenzy. So yeah, I was reading a bit about frenzy just a bit earlier because I was reading that essay that was written about this game called The Pale Blood Hunt. And what he was saying is that frenzy is very fast knowledge of the great ones, or knowledge of something that you can't really deal with yet, as opposed to insight, which is kind of like the slow accumulation of knowledge. Too late. All right, I'm opening it. Oh my god. So it's like your brain can't process it, so you take damage. God. That's funny. Yeah, I could see someone just approving it, not knowing what the fuck it is. Because they didn't look hard enough. They just, I don't know, they had a bad day. They're just going through the motions. Pretty amazing. Pretty amazing. Fuck! Not fighting these guys very intelligently. What I want to try to figure out is how to get that item. Yeah. That's not very smart, is it? Yeah, that's... I don't... Just, like, that is fat material. I don't know about that. A mosaic? That's pretty funny. Yeah, what'll end up happening is people won't be able to see it, first of all, even if it's approved, but they'll say it looks too blurry. I've gotten that before. I've gotten an emote not approved because it's just the features were too small on it. Fuck, I hate that. You know when I can't get to an item? You're back, King of Soups. Everything working all right now? No, it's the one that works at Twitch. Yeah, I don't know anyone that works at Twitch. Fortunately. Where did I die? Where did I die? I think it was against those three dudes, wasn't it? Might as well get my blood. There he is. There's that bastard. Might as well get those blood echoes back. Take a look at. See if you can see this guy's lantern, by the way, guys. If you guys weren't watching earlier today, I noticed that the lantern is covered with eyeballs. Blood echoes retrieved. Fuck, I have like almost as many blood echoes as after I killed Victor Amelia just from these guys. Hey, I think this will get approved. It's even worse on PC? I don't know. I don't know what's going on then, King of Soups. I don't think anyone else is having the same issue as me. There's nothing much I can do. I'm just streaming directly from the PS4 and I have limited control over how it handles stuff, so. Oh, fuck! I don't think I'm gonna fight that guy right now. So I went this way before. Gotta go down. That dog ran right into that fire. Nice. I ain't cursed, you're cursed. Oh. Oh man, I fucking hate dogs in these games. They're so hard to hit. See what Alfred has to say. I think he's this way. See if he has anything new to say. Or is he even here? He's not. Alfred's gone. Interesting. Okay. I wonder if we're going to run into him again. So Alfred told us about Kanehurst a bit. And he also told us about Healing Church. He's interested in ensuring that Master Ligarius, who is the leader of his faction of hunters, is martyred. He went to Castle Kanehurst to rid the world of the vile bloods. So maybe he's moved on in that quest line. Oh, another kidnapper. So I don't think this is the right way to go. Gotta be the other way. I have an idea. Why are you always streaming? I love this game, Sweet Assassin. And I want to stream it for you guys. Not that I mind it. Go give Sweet Assassin a follow. Go give My Name is Sandy a follow. Cthulhu Smash, The Wrestler, all excellent streamers. And part of our amazing community of amazingness. Oh, you can eviscerate. You can visceral attack these guys. I didn't know that. I think it might be this way. It's been a while since I've gone this way. Why the fuck are you streaming? I'll keep watching. Oh, I missed. Not good. Oh, fuck. Oh, fuck. No way. Yeah. fuck. Oh. Oh, man. He stuns when he charges like that. Or my name. I was just saying that I hate your guts, wrestler, and I want you to die a horrible death. There we go.
With his fucking stomach out!
Oh, fuck! They go for the eyes, those crows. Time to do some fashion souls. I might want to switch back. Oh, okay, we picked this up, the black church garb. Let's it looks really good, actually. Not good frenzy resist, not very good beasthood. Good otherwise. And I don't think I read the description either. So let's do that. Attire of Healing Church Hunters. So we've heard of Workshop Hunters before, and now Healing Church Hunters. The Holy Shawl, a symbol of the Healing Church, flutters proudly on their backs. Most Healing Church Hunters are elementary doctors who understand the importance of early prevention of the scourge achieved by disposing of victims. And even potential victims before the signs of sickness manifest themselves. So, their black attire is synonymous with fear and that peculiar yarn of madness. So, this is kind of the first indication that the Healing Church is up to no good. So, they've got these doctors going around that are killing people even before signs of sickness manifest themselves, and people are associating it with fear. So people are fearing the church. So there's some point where the church maybe becomes less about healing people and more about, I don't want to say like sustaining itself, but like trying to prevent the outbreak from happening, and they may be killing innocent people even as a result. Surgical long gloves. Is that part of that set? Church engages in the hunt in a medical capacity. When a cancer is discovered, one must pinpoint its location, reach in, and wrench it from the host's bosom. Pretty nasty. And then we've got the black church trousers. Tired of Healing Church Hunters. Most Healing Church Hunters are on the truth. So this is basically the same thing. Fear and the peculiar yarn of madness. So this is what the minus the hat, because I don't have the right hat. Is there a hat for this? Black church hat. Same thing. Pretty damn foreboding. Dark shit. One of them Scientologists. I'll be back in 1 second, guys. Just have to go to the washroom. Like, almost gonna pee my pants. Scientologists? Think older. My name is Sandy. do. Crisis averted, guys. I didn't pee my pants. You come here often? Yeah, I don't really dig this outfit, so I'm gonna switch off it. It's kind of creepy. I dig the top hat. Black hood's not bad too. And the hunter cap. It's kind of cool. But I think the top hat looks cool on my character, even if I don't use all of that, all of the gear from that set. Kind of like it with the hunter garb. I don't necessarily wear the stuff with the best stats for trousers. That looks pretty cool. All right. Let's carry on. I think it might be this way. I need to go. Always fashion souls. Always. Always and forever. One thing you'll notice though. Oh, you. No, not you. The other you. Oh, is he getting away? Fuck. I wanted to kill the little thing that was crawling on the ground because it was going to give me probably twin bloodstone shards. Yeah, what I wanted to point out was, you can't see it anymore, what that guy was wearing looked very similar to this, right? But it was, well, it looks kind of cool, but it was white instead of dark. So that guy is part of the church. I don't know why he's so huge, but he's part of the church. Hey, Kudman, what's up? What is up? How you doing tonight, or this morning, or this afternoon? Whatever time it might be where you are. This isn't the right way. Fuck. Man, I'm just like fucking wandering around. But that's fine. I like that about this game. It's hard to keep a mental map of the city. And it's like that on purpose. Which reminds me, I should unequip this, equip the pebbles for pulling people. Oh, 9 a.m. Cool. I love playing for people while they're eating. I don't know what it is. I like it. What you eating? What you eating? Is it to the left, maybe? Hate those flamethrowers. Pizza! The Breakfast of Champions, dude. That's awesome. What kind of pizza? Love it. I had pizza for dinner last night. All that talk from you guys about chicken pizza during the stream. I decided to order one. This is it. This is it. This is the ticket. Right. So I don't know if you guys remember these two from before, but I think they'll have be singing a different tune now.
Oh, enough with you already. Can't just go with you.
Well, he's not. What about her?
Oh, thank goodness. You're a hunter, aren't you, dear? Might you know the safe place?
Ah.
It's long and have very little of the incense left. Please, there must be some nice place to run off to.
Barbecue chicken pizza. So I could send her to Yosefka's clinic, but I don't trust Yosefka. She seems to have changed personalities. When I first talked to her, she wanted us to send to not send anyone there and to leave her alone, and then all of a sudden she wanted us to send everyone there because she wanted to cure them. But we have sent someone to Odin Chapel and she survived, so let's send her there. Pizza everywhere. Okay, so I just sent her there. What does this guy have to say now?
What's this two-bit nonsense you're peddling? I heard you told that wench about some shelter. Well, she's a damn fool to trust an outsider. Know why? Well, her sort's probably just fixing to feed some of your coin.
So she's, he's saying her sort. She's a woman of the night. So she's kind of like a blood prostitute. That's what that's what he means by her sort. Right.
What crafty lies does the outsider have today? You think I'm an easy mark? Yeah? Well, give me your best shot.
So I'm going to tell him about the chapel also.
Yeah, sorry. Too sharp for that, bollocks. I know a superstition when I hear one. Outsiders. Even their lies are predictable.
Okay.
What? Still praying on folks with your book of lies? Yeah, fine. Come on, show me what you got. Tell me about your little safe place.
Telling you.
Yeah, sorry. Too sharp for that, bollocks. I know a superstition when I hear one. Outsiders. What?
Yeah, okay. What if I withhold information?
What, afraid your lies would... Yeah, I knew you'd back off. I just knew it. You're an outsider, you may be, but at least you know when you're bested.
Yeah, you got me. Pizza for dinner. Cheap little Caesars, but still. Yeah, I ordered from a local pizza place. So that guy has apparently called me out on my lies, even though I'm trying to save his ass. What about these other guys? Anyone else?
Thank you.
Whoops. All right. Never forgetty. Never forget it. Forget it. See how many guys I can get chasing me here. Oh, he's a fucking dog. Dogs are the worst. Okay. Stop chasing me. I want my blood back. Could you please give him my blood back? This is a damn finished. Just trying to help these guys out. Blood echoes back. So she's concerned about her baby. Someone kill her baby? Was it a beast that killed her baby? I think we'll find out more about that later. Hot game, want a pizza? If you could just push that pizza into the monitor, I'll lick the chat and taste some of that yummy pizza. And then over here, it sounds like someone's getting beat up. Yes, I can. Okay. I take no responsibility for any damage that occurs to your computer. Making that clear. Take for 140. You want me to pay you 140 bucks for your pizza? That doesn't seem like a very good deal for me. Okay, so we're gonna go back to the church. See if our new friends are there. Take it! There you go, I'm looking in the chat. Oh, they're not there yet. So let's go back to the Hunter's Dream. Maybe they'll appear. Kudman, where do you live? If it's 9 in the morning, it's gonna be like in Europe. I imagine. Let's level up some more. What is it?
Very well, let me...
Ah, Czech Republic, cool. Very cool. I'm gonna keep leveling up vitality. Oh no, Nippa's cheating on me. That's fine. He could cheat on me. Never gonna watch his casts again! What can I buy there with 10 US dollars? Probably a really tasty pizza. You mean in Canada? That's probably like... 13 bucks or something. 12 bucks in Canada. It's not that. It's not worth that much more. I should finally buy this hand lantern. Or did I already buy it? Fuck. Do I have two now? I think I have two. I think I have two fucking hand lanterns. So I can, I can use this hand lantern now if I want to. The only thing is it lowers stamina recovery, I believe. Tired, need sleep. Okay, wrestler. Good night. Pizza and some alcohol. Yeah, alcohol is so cheap. Alcohol is expensive in Canada. Let's just put it that way. It's cheaper everywhere else. I don't know why it's so damn expensive here. Thanks for chilling with me, wrestler. You were here for both the streams. It's pretty impressive. Ah, you live in wine country. Are you in, like, California? It's the first thing. When I hear wine country and the U.S., I think of California. But obviously there's other places... Oh, hello. Hello. Followed. Thanks, Goodman. Thank you for the follow. What do you have to say?
Oh, hello, dear. You weren't lying. This is a safe place. Thank you. I am in your debt.
Curtsy.
I'd like to tender my thanks, but I can't imagine what to offer. All I can give is my blood. But would you even take a whore's blood?
Yes.
Oh, good. Come close, dear. Don't worry, I've done this before.
Blood of Ariana. Let's read what that says. Blood taken from Ariana, Cathedral Ward, Woman of Pleasure. The sweet blood of Ariana restores HP and temporarily speeds stamina recovery. Members of the old healing church would know that her blood is similar indeed to precisely what was once forbidden. So there's something special about her blood. Precisely what was once forbidden. So heard before from Master Willem and Lawrence to fear the old blood. Maybe that's what this is referring to. Or maybe it's Ashen Blood. Because there's also the Ashen Blood disease that hit Old Yharnam. It does look dark, so maybe it's Ashen Blood. But, so she's a whore, she's a prostitute. But I don't think it's in the traditional sense of the word. I think it's more of her blood that she's selling to people instead of her body. Kill her, no! Not gonna kill her.
Oh, hello. Sorry, dear. You're much too eager. I've only so much blood, okay? Oh, hello. Sorry.
She doesn't have more blood to give me. So if I use the vial, I think she gives me another one. All right, so there's this way. There are a few different ways we can go, but I think what I want to do is this. Yeah, she's something to do. So something changed when nighttime hit. She went from being very, combative. Saying, I know all your tricks. Kind of similar to that guy I was talking to earlier. Not trusting me. She went from that to being, seeming, borderline crazy. When it turned into night. So, something about the nighttime is affecting the people around here. So this is what's gonna happen now, guys. Died. But I live! You're stuck here? So, basically that guy's kidnapped us and brought us to the unseen village. Yahar Ghul. Already dead. Yeah, I might not be ready for this area yet, but what I wanted to do is there's an NPC in here that I want to talk to. This is a tough area. Take a look at this guy. He's got some weird cage on his head. I ain't scared of no Yaha ghoul. The cold blood. Okay, so what is this? This is a message. This is a game message. This isn't a message left by the player. Madmen toil surreptitiously in rituals to beckon the moon. Uncover their secrets. If you guys, I had to actually look up surreptitiously so I could get the correct definition. Surreptitiously means secretly. So rituals to beckon. You've seen the moon. Is that the moon that they're talking about? Is there someone performing a ritual that brought that moon? Or strengthen the moon? Is that what's making people act crazy? Uncover their secrets. And who left this message? Is it... I mean, when we read messages from players, those are other hunters. So maybe this is another hunter that left us this message. A special hunter like us, maybe, who can dream, or who was able to dream. Lots of questions. Lots of questions. But whatever the rituals are, it has something to do, and who these madmen are has something to do with this area. So it looks like a dead hunter there. So maybe it was him that left that message. Doing another cutscene. Interesting that you mentioned that, Sandy. Miyazaki, who's the director of this game, when he was a young kid, he would read stories in English, but he couldn't understand all of the words. He didn't speak English that well when he was a kid. So he had to piece together the story based on the limited bits that he could read. And that's why his games are kind of like this. He'll provide item descriptions in different orders. Basically what he'll do is he cuts up the story into pieces and you digest them and you fill in the gaps with your own interpretations. So he tells his stories the way that he read them when he was a kid. And he used to like stuff like, he used to like medieval fantasy stuff. So just interesting that his experiences as a kid have affected the way that he tells a story. Big lamps. So fucking weird. So he doesn't use cutscenes very often, as a result. Tends to use text. Guys are tough. Cheesing them. Learning the no quiero pues. I don't know what that means. It is like learning. actually. Totally is. Fuck. I think there's a lantern up here, isn't there? Yeah, there is. I'm just gonna grab this lantern. Because I think I'm gonna die a lot in this area. Too cheesy for me. It's not over on this side. Holy fuck. Look at how much damage that kick does. I know, eh? Fuck. This looks like another hunter. So yeah, the other point that I wanted to make was that these guys seem to be kidnapping people. The moon. So, there's the ritual with the moon, right? And now we've got this moon rune that we've picked up. Secret symbol left by Carol, runesmith of Bergenworth. So, this is the first rune that we picked up, a Carol rune that transcribes inhuman sounds. And now we find out more about Carol. He was a runesmith of Bergenworth, which is where the whole thing kind of started. Transcription of moon is spoken by the Great Ones inhabiting the nightmare. So, before we saw... Carol transcribes inhuman sounds. Now we find out that those inhuman sounds are made by the Great Ones. So this allows us to gain more blood echoes. The Great Ones that inhabit the nightmare are sympathetic in spirit and often answer when called upon. Forward to the boss. I might not even do the boss in this section. I can't even remember what the boss is here. So we found out a lot there. First of all, the sounds that the Great Ones make are inhuman and cannot be understood by humans, it sounds like. Carol's found some way to understand them. And he's a runesmith, Bergenworth. And the Great Ones that inhabit the nightmare. We haven't really been to the nightmare yet, have we? Or any kind of nightmare. We've been to the Hunter's Dream, but not a nightmare. So they're sympathetic, which is weird that you'd have sympathetic beings in a nightmare. Twin Bloodstone Shards, we need that. Can't remember where I need to go to find that woman! Oh no! That's not the woman I'm talking about. So she's trying to scoop our eye out. And funny that she has a pebble in her inventory and the pebble looks like an eye. Or a Death Star. Eyes are a common motif in this game. We've seen it many times before. We saw it on the lanterns of those priests that we were fighting. Okay, that's not where I want to go. Fuck. This area is so creepy. Here are great ones. I just imagine an army of Dwayne the Rock Johnson. Nice. I have played Dark Souls, and I played Dark Souls totally blind. I played Dark Souls 2 before I started streaming. That was also blind. I haven't played Demon Souls yet. I think this is the way I want to go. There's someone there. This is a trap. This is a trap. I know it. Oh, I knew it. Trying to get my eyes on you. I actually, when I played Dark Souls, it was part of a competition with another streamer named Pocket Clint. The idea was who could finish the game the fastest. And whoever finished it the slowest had to buy the winner Dark Souls 3. And I unfortunately lost. Man, that sound. I wasn't taking the competition too seriously, though, to be honest with you. I was just trying to have a good time of it. With it. Open the side. Hello. Always a good idea, guys, to target things occasionally. As you're walking through, if you think they might be enemies. Fuck, there's two of those guys. Excuse me. So, Kudman, have you played Dark Souls? Sounds like you have. And how do you like that game compared to this, if you've played this one also? Come in here? Whoa! Oh! Oh shit! Fuck. It's fine. Took it sick. I'll have no one to spam on. Holy fuck, I just noticed every time you say something, you fucking spam that shit at the end, don't you? Every single time. I'm just looking back in the chat. You got your OP. On every fucking line. I like combat system in DS1, atmosphere and bosses more than DS2. I totally agree. There's very few ways that Dark Souls 2 is better than Dark Souls 1. From what I've seen. Bloodborne is definitely... The combat is definitely faster. It's so much more... Intuitive. This is, I didn't really look at this altar, but look at that. So there's another one of those skeletons. This looks like a child with one of those cages on his head. And then if we look up, I don't know, that head looks similar to the heads of the statues that we saw leading to Amelia. So I think that this is probably a great one. I think that's that statue is, and I know what that cage is, but we haven't figured out what it is in the game yet. If we look over here, what is that thing? We haven't seen anything like that before. Oh yeah, you know, I've heard that. I've heard that Dark Souls 2 PvP is the best of the series. So, I wonder what those little things are. Those little guys are. Fight clubs were cool. What do you mean, fight clubs? Oh, shit. Yeah. Twin Bloodstone shot. Jackson before plastic surgery. Maybe. I think, did I look around? I think I looked around all down here, right? I'm trying to find this. There's a woman that I didn't want to talk to. Then I kind of want to get the fuck out of here. Oh, here she is. Here she is.
In the name of the healing church, cleanse us of this horrible dream.
So she's saying, cleanse us of this horrible dream. She's asking the healing church for help. Sculpture. When someone summons multiple red phantoms to host a fight club, and the red phantoms can duel while the host keeps summoning people to fight. Oh, cool. Another dead hunter, maybe. Looks dressed kind of similar to me, actually. There's a woman. So she's looking for help. Let's talk to her and see what she says. Cowering in the corner. She must have been kidnapped as well.
Oh, please leave me be. Don't take me, please. Oh, please, dear God. Oh, please, don't. Oh.
Telling us to leave her be. So let's try something out, guys. And it's, you know, that's just so cool about this game. And the only reason why I know how to do this is because I've seen people play this before. Mainly Epic Name Bro showed me a lot about this game that there's no way in hell I'd ever be able to figure out. So if I dressed as someone from the church, let's see how she reacts. So, kind of looks similar to her, but there's a few differences. That little cape thing that hangs off the back of us is black, and that's because this is a, this is for the, attire of the Healing Church Hunters. She must be maybe a cleric of some kind?
Church, you've come to save me. Oh, thank you, dear saint. I have no words to express my relief. You can take this at least.
She's got Madman's knowledge, which gives us insight, right?
Sure to please an upstanding member of the church like you. Oh, thank you so much. Dear gods.
So let's just read, Madman's knowledge again. Skull of a madman touched by the wisdom of the great ones. You see an insight. Making contact with eldritch wisdom is a blessing, for even if it drives one mad, it allows one to serve a grander purpose for posterity. So it seems like they're interested in, the church is interested in contact with the great ones as well. Or learning about the great ones, at least.
Thank you. I was seized on the street by a hulking brute in the cathedral ward and locked up here.
Same with me.
Many others, but they've been taken away. And I've heard moans echoing in the distance ever since. So, the hunt is on tonight. Then the streets are perilous, and every door will be shut tight. That isn't my place to ask, but do you know somewhere that might take me in?
Funny you should ask. I hear Odin Chapel is quite nice this time of the year.
Oh, thank you so much. I'll set out as soon as I can. I pray for success on your hunt, kind hunter.
Anything else?
I'll set out as I pray kind.
Alright, that's kind of what I wanted to do here. But we'll come back here later. When I'm a bit stronger. Trying to collect people for the church, the chapel. Do you have some church clothes? Yeah, I knew about that. Always. Take this disgusting stuff off. Look way cooler in this outfit. You just stay there. Although, no, I only had like 5,000 echoes. I don't need them. Return to the Hunter's Dream. So, wow, guys, we learned a lot there. A lot of stuff. Let's see if we have enough Twin Bloodstone shards to upgrade our weapon. We do. So we just don't have the blood echoes, but I think I've got, yeah. Hit cold blood, that'll do it. And then pair, no, don't need to. Can we pick up any new blood gems? Did. Oh no, I wanted to keep this. Do I need to actually? Increases my attack versus beasts. I'll leave it for now. Then I'm gonna go back to the Cathedral Ward. Let's see if that nun or cleric or whatever has gone to Odin Chapel. Uden. See if we can talk to her. Doesn't look like she's here yet. But let's see if you have anything new to say.
There ain't a peep to be heard, not in the old town. I doubt there's any more out there. God save us. Yharnam's done for.
Oh.
There ain't no more Sir Yharnam's.
There are, though. There's that guy. Just not sure when I can. I'm not sure when I can bring him here. Anyways, let's just explore around now. So we've got a few different paths to travel. Let's try them all out. Oh god. See where the game takes us. Ooh, a chest. Communion. Another rune. Fortunately, I can't equip them yet. Secret symbol left by Carol, runesmith of Bergenworth. Several runes relate to blood, including communion, which raises the maximum number of blood vials one may carry. This rune represents the Healing Church and its ministers. Blood ministration is, of course, the pursuit of communion. So one thing we're finding out from here is that Carol was around during the Healing Church, the reign of the Healing Church. And notice, like, This one's really quite faint, isn't it? That particular rune. Interesting. We've got a bunch of sarcophagus. All adult size. Oh god. Don't shoot me! I'm friendly, I swear! No! Yes! Oh. Well. I need that. Twin Bloodstone Shards. Two of them. That's awesome. Oh, there's one of those big guys around here, isn't there? Can I get back up? Can I get back up? It's like I could fall down. Maybe. Into bed, take it easy, Luckless. Alright, see you, Sandy. Thanks for chilling. Glad you're following me again. Fucking Twitch is so weird. Yeah, let's go down. Trying to see if there's items that I want to collect. There's one there. One there. Get that. think if I do this... here? Yeah, that's the ticket, guys. Is this Resident Evil 4? Oh god. Kill Bill, thanks for hosting the Kill Bill raid. Everyone go follow Kill Bill. It kind of looks like Resident Evil 4, doesn't it? It kind of looks like Resident Evil 4, but it's not. It's not. Salty old man, what's up? Nippa, what's up? I heard you're cheating on me with Nikki, which is fine. Chaco Diva, am I pronouncing that right? What's up? Thanks. Thanks for the raid, guys. You guys are awesome. You guys are awesome. What were you playing, Kill Bill? Resident Evil 4? I assume? Or was it Wolfenstein? Messenger Top Hat. Really glad I got that. You said it right! It's Dead Space. I know. It's because you're killing Germans. And Nippa has the secret desire to kill his own people. So that's why he was watching you. I understand. I understand, Nippa. Wolfenstein. Miss Nikki's. Oh, you did. That's true. That game is fucking amazing. I've heard it's good. I've heard it's good. I've heard it's good. Does it have multiplayer or is it just single player only? Laid back booty. Laid back booty. What's up? What is up? Wasn't there another item? Okay, there it is. How the fuck do I get that one? With great care. Madman's knowledge. Oh man. Lead single player, guess I haven't looked into it. Who are you dating? She's dating everyone on Twitch at the same time. Kill Bill gets around. Okay, I think I... Okay, I see. I see. I see what's going on there. Points and shoots, forgets to reload. I don't know if... Have you guys ever played Counter-Strike Go? It's funny how many bad first-person shooter habits you've got to break to play that game. You can't reload all the time. Because you'll get shot. But I tried that game and I was just constantly reloading, and cause it's just what I've been trained to do over time, and did not work out well. I think he meant to whisper that. I hate you. Okay. Dark Fire, thank you for that. I love you too. Tonic, what's up? What's up, man? Everyone's coming to Lovelock's channel. Why do you hurt me so? Okay, here we go, guys. Oh shit! Okay, I survived. Probably should have fallen. Oh, I could have done that way better. deep belly laugh.